No, thank you very much, Vittorio. That's totally no issues at all. It has been a very informative presentation from you. You've started in terms of giving us insights in terms of the actualities, in terms of the risks on the ground. You've talked about the different approaches on how these can be addressed in terms of different charging modalities, in terms of looking at systems integration. The other factors that related to, for example, the positioning, you've given us a picture of what might be possible in the future, and you've given us a run through of the different standards. So thank you very much for those insights. I would encourage everyone, if you have any questions to Vittorio, you can chat them in the chat box or give us or raise your hands. But maybe one question, essentially, Vittorio, from my end, considering the state, for example, of the Philippines in terms of the current, EV developments that are focusing, we have a lot of proliferations in terms of small light electric vehicles, as well as electrification of some of the public transport vehicles, the minibuses that we have. And we are in the countries in the process of coming up with the EV bill that's also looking into charging infrastructure. In terms of like the standards that you've presented, what's your main recommendation in terms of the key ones that we can consider in terms of importance and in terms of urgency that the very start, like these are the ones that we need to look into, put in place as early as possible.
Yeah,
Thank you.
In my opinion, for the smallest vehicle, two, three, four wheelers, what we call in our field L category, so less than a small car, let me say. In general, there is a good starting point. The energy on board requested is largely less. Sometimes the voltage is very low. The power to be used to the charging is not so high. And that, as said before, is not the solution, but put you in a good position to start the process. There are a few standards of the one I mentioned, you find in the slide, that are the safety and mode of charging for this type of vehicle. And I feel that following this, you can have, on top of the classical home charging that will be done with classical socket and plug, leaving the problem of the safety to the guys doing that, because in private environment, this is the trend, up to when a fire will impact also the people living closer. And in this case, I don't know how much private will be, but this is a side problem. Hopefully people will be wise in doing that. But in public area, this help to have also for this small vehicle a safer and easy way to charge. So these are the first. Other elements for this vehicle, very relevant, can be the swapping. I suggest to take care of the standard on the swapping, because swapping in this segment seems to be, as the Gogoro experience tell us, something that is not asking for large infrastructure and complexity. And due to that, can be done also at the end by the end user himself with a good, safe approach. Staying on what Corey has been saying in the first presentation, that this swapping asks for design, making this swapping, fitting the replacement a lot of time without damages of the system. Other problem, totally different buses, because you have both. The first is addressed with this. The second ask, the more you want to use the bus in the day, today ask for DC fast charging. And for DC fast charging, again, in the list, you find some safety standard for that. I feel in the short term will be conductive. You know, the experience also in our European project steered by IBB with Madrid of fast charging the battery at the stop of the bus. In this case, clearly this ask for a level of safety higher. There we speak about very high power, very high energy, and people that is coming in out the bus while the charging is in progress. And for that, there are some standard addressing specifically among the list this topic. So for the smallest, make safe also public cable-based low-power charging and look at the swapping. For the biggest, DC fast charging. These are the two main directions I suggest to take care of.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, Vittorio, for those.
Another element, just to complete, for instance, Madrid experience, they are imagine to make higher DC fast charging in the, let me say, place where the bus are recovering the night. And they realize that the bus asks for this infrastructure early morning, early night, and they want to open this infrastructure during the day, also to taxi driver. So another interesting element for ways to manage the infrastructure and leverage the investment is to try to understand if different end user can complementarily use the same infrastructure to make its cost better exploited in terms of usage and effectiveness for the community.
Thank you. I received a question here that was chatted to me. If you can very quickly address this. For the adoption of the priority standards that were flashed, can you give some insights in terms of the needs for huge or costly infrastructure equipment to conduct the testing or checking of these standards in general? Or in general, do the adoption of these standards require costly testing infrastructure and equipment, essentially?
In general, at least in Europe, US, China too, the approach is the following. What you need to put in place a component is a homologation process or certification process, depending if it is a car, if it is a computer, what it is. In Europe, we have a process to certify this component, but there is in all the world, in each region. And this is what you have to be compliant for the law side. In general, these regulation, these certification processes, in the technical check to verify if the device is compliant or not, use the standards. So standards have to be intended as technical neutral document are written by different players that are competitors. It's not, let me say, a matter of competition, it's a matter to have together a common background to do the right things. And they are applied in the homologation certification processes. So to understand the cost is probably a matter to understand, and that's a region is country-based, in your country, which are the rules to be satisfied to, for instance, install an infrastructure and verify all the steps. In case, at least our experience in Europe, in case you want to make a big DC fast charger, is a multiple process. You need someone to certify the safety of the electricity reaching the place, another one verify the connection of that to the DC fast charger, a third one verify that the fast charger is in line with the rules of safety and so on. And this depends on the local basis. Clearly, higher are the power and the voltage, more complex are also the instrument to make the test. That's out of discussion.
Thank you very much, Vittorio. I think you've provided us with very useful insights.